Waiting for the performance to start. This is your boy, Juan Rafael, the vet a cappella group.
Hey, 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 I need money, huh?
We don't have any more money.
You're lying. You're lying! You're working! That stupid son of yours is working! I know you have money. Are you trying to hide away from me?
I'm telling the truth. We really don't have
any- Nonsense! You better find me some money, or I'll hurt you even more!
Ma! Ma! Are you okay? Did Pa hurt you? Ma? There's really nothing I can do. Ma suffers in silence. Danny just gonna stand on the side of Pa. Look, don't think that Danny's a bad guy or anything. He's my elder brother. He's just stressed out. It's sad that he had to quit school though.
Listen here. I want you to make sure you do well in school. I was useless in school. That's why I failed all my exams. But you have a bright future ahead of you. You get 3 years out of time. Let me go to work so I can support the family and the studies too. Just promise me that you'll study hard and be successful, okay?
Yes, Danny. I will. I promise. And Danny, promise me you will stay out of trouble too.
Yes, little sister, I promise.
But Danny, he broke his promise. We spent a lot of time together. also went window shopping. When he didn't have any money, we just go to the beach. Or stay at home and watch DVDs. Being in love made me forget about the misery that's been happening in my own home. One day,
hello. Yes, Danny, she's here with me. Nothing, she's just doing her work. Okay. So, it's for you.
Hello. Yeah, Danny. Wait, what? How? It's my mom. I did this to you, right? Mom, why do you let Pa keep hurting you like this, Mom? We cannot let Pa hurt you. Come on, Mom. Please, talk to me.
I don't know, Sophie. After all these years, I tried to endure whatever your Pa has done to me. Look, I just don't want you and Danny to live without a father. But at the rate it's going, I'll eventually die and be left without mother.
Don't say that. I don't want to lose you.
I don't want to lose you too, Sophie.
Because Smile ends herself in the hospital, I decided not to go home. Your Pa will be there. And if Ma's not around, he will start asking me for money. Then he'll be able to take care of himself. Jay said I could stay with him for a couple of days, since his parents were away. But a greater danger awaits when we were together. Let's call it temptation.
God.
girl smiles. La 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 la.
The boy smiles back.
The girl walks to the boy.
If I was a girlfriend, I'd never let you go. Keep you in my arms, boy. You'll never be alone. He took her hands in his.
Sitting next to each other, all the boys roll up.
Transformers, heroes in disguise.
Everyone swoons and sighs.
Ooh. Ah.
And embrace.
The girl pulls herself away.
The boy slowly.
Sophie, whatever happens, please believe me. I'll be there for you. I really, really love you.
I love you too. Being in love, I realize that love is a very strange feeling.
It makes you do things you know you shouldn't do.
Love makes you happy and carefree. But sometimes, it makes you worry and feel so helpless.
There's such a sacrifice to be made. Yet in return, love gives you so much more.
What is love? I don't understand what is love.
L-O-V-E. Love. Love is a contradiction.
Oh, by the way, Ma finally got out of the hospital. She decided to file a police report. She was given the PPO. Personal protection order. With the PPO, Pa cannot come near Ma to hurt her anymore. Ma also decided to ask Pa for divorce. He grew violent. That's when he was arrested. By the police. And was sent to jail.
Gosh, the whole family's a bunch of losers!
But doesn't she have that boyfriend now?
Yeah, the guy cheats.
She is such a flirt. That cheat woman, you know, I think. She's pregnant.
Pregnant?
Hello, excuse me? What is this? Why are you bad-mouthing me?
What are you talking about? What makes you think that we are talking about you?
Wow, how dare you! What have I ever done to you for you to be so evil to me?
Don't flatter yourself, Sophie. Who cares about you, stupid?
So it's true what they say? Your partner is Jesus, baby.
Of course it's true. She is such a cheap woman. She'll sleep with almost anyone.
How dare you? Somehow, the kids in school found out about my pregnancy. I guess it's just a rumor that someone has been spreading. But ever since I fought with Dion and Fionn, I'm sure everyone knows the truth now.
Sophie, I have no right to interfere into your personal life. But as your teacher, I have the responsibility should I feel that your education and future has been compromised. If what they say is true, you're in trouble, my dear girl. But Sophie, I know you're a smart girl. And I want you to know, there's help for you. Hold on. Here's the number I want you to call. There are people there who will help and guide you on matters about teenage pregnancy. Sophie?
Yeah?
Promise me that you'll call?
Yeah, I will. I promise. Thank you, Mrs. Ryder. I got the hotline number that Mrs. Ryder gave to me. I'm just so relieved that she's so understanding. She treated me like an adult, and I feel like I could decide what to do, and the decision is my own. But before I could decide, somehow, fate has a way of interfering into my life.
Chase! What have you done to my sister?
Danny, what's wrong? What happened to Sophie?
What's this rumor about you getting her pregnant?
Danny, Sophie's my girlfriend. I love her. I care for her. I wouldn't let anything happen to her.
But clearly you haven't cared enough. Did you know that she's pregnant? With your child? You know what that means? She might have to quit school and her future will be gone. It's all because of you.
Sophie's pregnant.
Oi! Chase! I owe my life to you, and I'm indebted to you for that. But getting my sister pregnant and ruining her life is really something else.
Danny, let's talk about this calmly.
No! I want you to stop being a coward. I want you to be responsible and face the consequences.
That night, Danny fought with Chase. The whole gang found out about what had happened. Brother, turn against brother, they shouted.
I'm
just don't want. Yeah, I'm sorry.
No, we get that.
No, no, it's okay. It's okay. Just don't want. Yeah, I'm really sorry. And yeah, I love her. Okay.
My brother Danny passed away in the hospital. They couldn't save him from the stab wounds. His kidney was punctured.
Sophie, thank you for assisting the police. We have investigated Danny's murder and we have arrested the whole gang, and the gangmate who killed him was given life imprisonment. Tis has been cleared of all charges. He was unarmed and was reluctant to fight your brother, Danny, at the time of the murder.
Thank you, Inspector Mossin.
It's our duty, Sophie.
My brother died. Another man in prison. All because of me. Sophie, what has happened to this family? What have I done to deserve all this suffering? I lost my son, and you, my one and only hope, is pregnant. It's me. I'm just a bad mother who can't keep her family together. It's all my fault. It is nobody's fault. That is why you are here. You and your daughter need to undergo counseling. For the both of you to get out of this misery, you need to stop blaming yourself for whatever that had happened. I'm lucky to have Sophie to help me get on with life. And I'm blessed to have Ma.
The both of you will need to rebuild your life together. It might not be the easiest thing to do right now, but have faith. The both of you will be able to do it. The future is bright, but I gotta leave your past to move on to the future.
The future. Ma and me continue to get counseling. Ma got a job. She's so much happier now. She has a lot of friends. As for me, I continued my studies and I did very well for my exams. Turns out, this whole incident has truly made me so aware of what a wonderful life I have.